Good morning, everyone. Good afternoon, good evening, wherever you are watching this video from at this hour. Today is the 28th of August, 2021. I hope our week was profitable. Before I start, I'm just going to say this. This video is not about financial advice. It's not a financial advice. This sounds as a disclaimer. This is not a financial advice. I'm just going to be speaking on something that I think can help you moving forward as a forex trader. We're just going to go and analyze the peak for the week, because like I said, I normally send out peaks on Instagram and Facebook. And also on Monday, I did like I just touched on the peak that I sent out on YouTube. I posted it on Monday for the peak was sent out on Monday, the 16th of August, 2021. So we're just going to go now and then check and see actually what actually happened and all that. And also there was a peak I sent out that was I think that was July. I'm going to check it. That July or early August. I was long on that peak because I analyzed the chart on a daily time frame. So I was going long on that peak. So I remember someone asked me like a week ago, and he was asking, "So are you still on this particular peak?" I said, yes, I'm still, because my bias is still very strong and I'm still bearish on that particular peak. So because I went on that peak for a long position, not a short position. So I know what I was expecting. It was worth it, because like I said, you might not be privileged to have different account that you use, that you can have the luxury of, okay, let me go long on this one. Or let me go, you understand. So like I said, we have 15 live accounts. Like the last time I told you, we have 15 live accounts. And today, because this week we added two, now we have 17 live accounts within a forest account. And also we are just waiting for one, because they are still verifying and all that. So we are just waiting. If they approve it this week, then we have 18 or next week, we're just waiting. So I went long on that. I have the account that I use for long, for scalping and all that. And someone sent was asking me which robotic signal do I use. I've told you guys before, those things don't work. Robotic signal, it has never worked, it's never going to work. Those guys selling it, they are just looking for their daily bread. They are trying to cajole you because they have already failed as a forex trader, and they are looking for something to survive. And the only way is for them to provide you a robotic signal and then show you a fake MT4 balance, and then you are convinced that, oh, these guys are making money, so let me purchase their robotic signal and all that. At the end of the day, you give them the money, you lose the money, and then you also blow your account. So I've said it, these things don't work. It has never worked, it's never going to work. So don't believe me. I know how I analyze my chart. I backtest a lot, and I know the patterns that I'm looking for in a particular peak. I backtest, I know the pattern I'm looking for, and I'm still hoping to hear a fundamental that might creep in at any time. I'm always alert to that as well, because like I said, the bias analysis, you have to take from the previous data to measure the current data, and then you're still open and waiting for any data that becomes available. Like the analogy I gave you on Monday, was it on Monday or Tuesday? I think it was on Tuesday, yeah, regarding the New Zealand dollar, when they went full lockdown. So you can understand those things, so you don't fall for these guys that are trying to cajole you. I told you the last time, if they claim that their robotic signal works, which is fine, okay, if you claim that your robotic signal works, then use your robotic signal, analyze the chart for us, then let's come back at the end of the week to check and see, oh, this is the, did we achieve what did you achieve, because you are the one that is using the robotic signal, did you achieve the result that you said you were going to achieve? Because now we are all live, now we are seeing what you, so that should give you this awareness that these things don't work. If I'm so confident that I can generate uh what's it called uh uh 200% on with my robotic signal on the trade, why would I be busy selling it to you? Like the last time I told you, I said, these people, they have families. They say charity begins at home. If they are so sure, you ask them, how many of you have families? They say yes. So from in your family, how many of them are millionaires? Like you claim that you are, none. So you go and start with them, make them millionaires, then you at least, you know, you come back when you're doing a party, then you everyone will gather and say, wow, this guy made us millionaires through his robotic signal. Then other people can be confident enough and convinced enough to buy your robotic signal. Like I said, told you guys, it doesn't work, that's never worked, and it's never going to work. So I'm just going to share the screen because me, even me, I'm a little bit tired. I've not slept. Since last night. Today is the 20th of August. So I'm just going to, I've been studying since, and now I still have some works to do. So we're going to share the screen and then we'll just go. I will first of all go now to the one I said, because that peak was very, I was long on that. Because like I said, we have account that I go long on some accounts, I go short, and then I scalp as well. So that's why I told you guys, anyone that comes out and say there's just one strategy in the market doesn't know what he's doing. There's a lot of strategy. The one that works for you, if you are privileged and you are blessed enough to know more than one strategy that you are using and they are all working for you, then good. But if you are not privileged and just have just one strategy that you are using and it's working for you, good. Our aim is to make money in the market. But don't say that because the one you're using is working for you and so the other one is not working for people. People are dead ass. I do scalp. If I'm in the mood for scalping and I spot a trend, I spot a trend on there, I go on scalp and I just do my scalping and I know the pattern I'm looking for. I go on a lower time frame, check the pattern I'm looking for, open, and then I'm out of the trade. So it's not every time that I scalp, but if I'm in the mood that maybe, let's assume I'm not doing anything, I spot a trend like, okay, yeah, there's something here, then I go on scalping. So don't let anybody deceive you and say, we just have just one strategy in the market. That person doesn't know what it's saying, honestly, because we have a lot of strategy that people are using. Someone that is has a 9-to-5 job might not necessarily go on long position. He might come back from work, from his activity, in the evening, and let's say by 7 o'clock, maybe after doing this or chores and all that, by 7 o'clock he opens his computer, and then you can go on scalping. That's why I also I need to advise some people. If you are having a night, a fight, maybe by on let's say on Monday, I will speak more on that. What you need, how you need to, as a if you are working 9-to-5 job, so you don't go and quit your job. Someone will promise you come, you make millions. Now you want to quit the job you already have and you want to go into trading. Not everyone is not meant to be a full-time forex trader. There are some. If everyone is meant to work for themselves, then you ask yourself, if I'm meant to work for myself, you're meant to work for yourself, and he's meant to work for himself, who is now? We are still going to employ someone to assist us. Who will now assist us? So don't be deceived. Yeah, you can be working your 9-to-5 job and still be profitable in the market if you know what you're doing. So maybe by Monday or Tuesday, I'll be speaking more on that. So I will advise you on how to spot a trend and all that. So now we're just going to share this point. I will need to go now first to, let me go to this one. So I will show you what I spotted on this. But this, I can't, let me first of all go. I'm just checking this position that I took now, because I've been on this position for a long time. Trying to get this first one. So let me just first of all, which one should I share now? Okay, let me go to our YouTube, our Instagram page first. Then, oops. I hope you can see this. This is our Instagram page. I hope you can see. Let me. I don't know why this thing is not. So this is the one I want to. When did I post it? I'm not sure. like I told you guys the other time, our Instagram page is a new page. You can go and check it out. And we have been posting some, I don't know if it's this, this one was last week. Let me check this one. Yeah, this is the, yeah, this is the, this was the peak, but it's not, it's very small. It was posted, yeah, August 2nd. Today is 20th, that is 18 days ago. It was posted on the 2nd of August on a daily time frame, if you can see. Let me see if I can zoom in. No, it's not this one. Let me just, let me. First. Okay, we're back. So I just wanted to go so I can at least zoom out. You can see here where my mouse cursor. I hope you guys can see me. Let me just stop sharing. So I'm sure that you guys can see me. Okay, let me share the screen again. Share. So this is the you see it was posted on the, this is when I sent them the chat so that they can edit the and put our logo and then send it out on Facebook and Instagram as well. So it was posted on the 2nd of August at about 7 a.m. So if you see, yeah. So this was my where I said there's a strong resistance at this same level. So if you can see, this is a daily time frame. There was a strong resistance that also acted as support. I don't know if you can see where my mouse cursor is now, as support. So there was something I saw here. You see where my mouse cursor, I actually drew and I spotted this. If you go back date and back test this, you'll see where it was coming from. So it has acted as resistant before. So this place was my entry level. There was rejection at this level for the past 11 days before we got into it. So I spotted a position here. I spotted a trend here. So that was what gave me the bias for a long position. It was on a daily time frame. So let's go now to the live market to see what actually played out, because I know this week on Monday we got, it's not what I'm looking for. Okay, yeah, this is the live market scan now. Today's, I don't know why this thing doesn't show date anymore. Today, if you can see, you see the market is live. So today is the 20th of August, 2021. So like I said, you saw where my bias was coming from. So actually, we now saw a rejection at this level. If we count now, how many days, because on a daily time frame, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, we got into the market. Like I told you, if you go and watch one of the video I posted on YouTube, I came back to this peak again. I was analyzing something, then it's like when I was checking, looking for something, I just bumped into the chart. So I just checked and analyzed for them. So we got into the market here with this candlestick. Let me zoom out so you can see. With this bearish candlestick, because we drew the chart when the candlestick was. So we got into the market. It was 2 days after, I can still remember. It was 2 days after we got into the market with this candlestick, because it was a pending position. So 2 days after, our position was activated and we got into the market. Then we saw a struggle. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That was when someone asked me, I remember it was last year, someone was asking me, sent me an email and said, are you still on this peak? I said, yes, I'm still much on the peak because I've not seen the reversal in my analysis. Because you know one thing I always, because I analyze a lot of charts, so I try as much as possible to detail my chart very well so that if I bump into the chart, I can easily remember what I saw. And that's why you see a lot of time I detail my chart very well. I say, okay, this is my bias and this is my alternative scenario. So that once it breaks the reverse and to my alternative scenario, I'm easily able to understand and then exit the market. So now we saw a struggle, and then this week we also saw a breakthrough. To actually, we actually made a lot of money from this, a lot of pips from this trade because it's on a daily time frame. So we now saw a breakthrough to actually hit our TP1, and now we are open for TP2. But mind you, I'm locking my profit here first. Just going to adjust and then lock my profit here because it's on a daily time frame. So I'm still going to hit TP2, but yeah, because there's no fundamental out. That's out here that might encroach into my analysis. So I'm still very hopeful for TP2. So this is it. You see what patient in the market can also resort to. I waited, but that's why I always say this to you guys. You might not be privileged to have a lot of account to say, okay, I might open a position and leave it there. You might know, so you need to know what works for you so that you can be patient enough to say, okay, let me leave this thing there. Because forex trading is all about patience. You need to know how to control your emotion as well. So I stayed on this position. I wasn't even checking because I knew that, yes, if there's a reversal, I knew when to get out of the market. It's not about you say risk reward ratio and all that and all that. You need to know what might happen. You see what I said on this? I'm not feeling too well, so I'm struggling with my this issue. I've been going on for, the doctor asked me to have a rest, but still yet I'm still. And so what was I saying? So you see, like, opportunity for a safe position, a long breakout, a breakout above the strong resistance at. Because if I saw a breakout from here, from this level, this strong resistance, because you see, I drew a two line in between here. We saw that it respected this level for over 18 days or so, more than 18 days. So before we now finally saw a breakthrough now to actually our TP. This is a daily time frame. You can imagine the pips that we got out of this trade alone. So that's why I always say, you know what you're doing. Don't depend on this robot. They don't work. I was once in your shoe. I worked there, so I understand. You're looking for a robot because you just want to make quick money. These guys, they won't tell you, they want their own money. You are looking for money, they are looking for money. So the one that is more wise, that the one that is wiser will be the one that will come out with the pack. So if you are looking for money, just have this at the back of these people also. They are looking for money. You are looking for money in the market. They are looking for money in the market. So why can't they face the market and actually get the money from the market? Why are they not coming to you that you yourself, you are looking for money in the market? Why are they not coming to you to come and subscribe to their? So you need to be wise. You need to be wise. If you, I'm in the market looking for money. You are in the market looking for money, trying to make a trade and then make money. He is in the market looking for money. Now, if he has something to generate money, he won't be busy now looking for someone that is inside the market that he wants to cajole and defraud and collect his money. And at the end, if what you're using is working, then stick to it and leave other people out of it. You can't be deceived. You can't deceive me now that, okay, I should come and buy because I know it doesn't work. Because if I've tried it, so that's what I'm saying. When I tested it, I tried it, it doesn't work. It has never worked. It will never work. So don't be deceived. Know what you're looking for. This was my bias. I said, look at the resistance. There was a strong resistance here. It added a support. And we should backdate it now, but I don't want to. It also added that Do you see? You see, it has acted previously again as resistance again. I saw a four. And then you saw here again, we saw another resistance, we saw a four. It has acted as resistance, it has acted as support. So there was a big what's it called? My bias here was very strong that no, this thing is not going to, there's something in this for me. So I took the trade, I was long on it. That's why I also I told you guys, I know you might not be able to stay on the trade for that long. You might not be able to go on the one on a daily time frame. But at least you know if you can, if you are able to spot patterns, like what I'm going to show you now. I'm going to show you about the dodgy pattern as well that I used in this the other trade, and we made something good. Something good out of it, because I only post like one chart on our Instagram page, and then I post daily peak. If you go on the daily peak now, just go and check, go on our Instagram. I won't be doing that now because I need to analyze the other chart. If you go on our Instagram now, just go on the on the daily peak for short. People that are those are daily day trader that are always going on short. I also send that signals for them as well. If you go now, you see, you check the bias and this thing's always popping up. This one is the okay. Like we are done with this. This the one I just told you now. This Instagram. I don't know how to. I don't know them. So okay, yeah. Like this one, I think the only where we saw a rejection was this Bitcoin. We couldn't hit the 49K. But we got to 48. Yeah, so this Bitcoin, if you go to, okay, let me just, for argument's sake, so let me just go through them. Let me see if I can, I'm strong. Sorry, let me. Look for a free. We are going to come now to this one, and I'm going to show you the okay. Let's use this chart. This is a free chart. Let me just take out the, let me just remove the let me hide it. So this, which, let's go back now. Okay, USD card. Which, let's go, our target was 1.2549. And the other one was you. Okay, let's just quickly, is it this one? USD card. Yeah, you were. Target was what again? On that same day, the chart was posted on the, 4 days ago, that was on the 16th of August, that was on a Monday. So let's quickly just go through this. We posted it on the 16th, right? Yeah, 16th at this level. This is my mask answer. So we posted, our target was 1.2. Let me just. Uh, 1.2549. Okay, so we got we hit the TP was on a short distance that same day, right? No, yeah, on the 16th, we hit on the daily this candle, we hit the TP on that same day. This is the USD target was 1.5490. If you can go now, 1.45, is it 5 or 4? Yeah, that's correct. 1.2549. Yeah. So let's go now to the other one. Let's quickly just 1.50. Pounds 0.0 8541. Excuse me. So you see, this is not a guesswork. I do this analysis. I just go quickly and check it and check what I'm. That's why I also admonish you and I plead with you. Whenever I send that chart, signal, please go on your own, on your chart, analyze it first before you pick. That alone will also improve your mode of learning and you get used to it. So don't just I'll just send it out, then you dive into it without even knowing what you're doing. You are also, you need to know position. Oh, if I send it out, you need to position, okay, where is my entry level? Where is my entry level? So that you don't just dive in. Let me just sort of point. That way you are learning as well. You go on the chart, play with the chart. Even if you are not opening a position, draw chart, play with it. If you're not busy. One. You see? Isn't that 5-4-1, right? Yeah, 5-4-1. So yeah, we hit the TP. It was if you are long, it was like yes. So we did hit the TP, and this one was a good. Pips is about this one. You see, if you're making, like I said, this is not a financial advice. If you're making $1, $2 a day, you come back from work after working your 9-to-5 job, you come back and you take a peek, like you scalp, and then at the end of the evening, you make $50. Imagine adding $50 to your salary. You are making progress. So don't, because you want to make use, do an open eye, you don't go and buy what's it called, a signal that doesn't work. Our Bitcoin bias was, I think we didn't hit that Bitcoin, because even my Bitcoin is still open now. Let's check first. We can get this 59849. Our target on this one is 40. We are not on the loss. It's just doing this pullback. 49.849.47. So that's our target of Bitcoin. So we are still on that trade, but I think we didn't hit that trade on that day. Yeah. Right. See, we didn't. So we got to 48. Yeah, I go to 48. So if you go to 48 and you are still on that trade, this you would have exited that trade, that peak before we saw it fall. At least 49, you now go from 45 to 48. That's something you don't. If you remain on this peak, then you don't have you should blame yourself, but you don't have any cause to complain. So this was the short position, the buy. So let's go now to sell. The sell was USD yen 109.10. Let's just quickly watch now because I'm tired. I've not slept since, like, I was reading all through the night. And I just need to send this thing back so that I can edit and then I can at least study more USD yen, right? Because I'm just going, just hold on. I'm going to show you something on the other chart that we sent out this week. Where's this? Where's the, was it set position? This one was there. Okay. It was here. Our target was what? Let's just quickly go now. Target was what? 109.1. Where are you? Yeah, you see. You see why I'm laughing? 109.1. Immediately he touched base on that level. You see, immediately we now saw a rejection. You see, immediately, just look at this candle, this candlestick. This was what got us to 1 point. Because you go now is 109.1. Someone said, why is it that I'm not always looking at the camera? I've explained this to you. I'm struggling because this is a desktop. I have laptops here and all that lot, but I like to use the desktop because I'm able to analyze better. But my webcam is like this facing me, and my screen is here. So sometimes if I'm analyzing on the screen, I need to look at the screen. So just bear with me. It's not that I don't want to look at your face. It's just that I need to focus on what I'm doing. So because someone asked me that, so why is it that you're not looking? Why is it that you're not looking directly at this thing? So that's the reason. So you see this candle, we hit our TP on that same day, the 16th of August, at about 1 p.m. That's 13 o'clock. You can see the time frame on the on the bottom. Immediately we hit the TP, we saw now a rejection, a continuation upside. So this was the USD yen, right? USD yen. So also USD, AUD, USD. Our target was 0.7320. Let's just quickly go through now. Did we? Yeah, we did. This was 16. We 16. 16. I know it was about 7. Yeah, I did the chart in the morning. It was here. So our target was. We did on that same day. It was short, but at least it's something for those people going short. So it was 1.20, and it was here on that same day. I think it was, which one is this one? It was still the same time. It was still look at this red candle, this bearish candle. It was that same at about 1 a.m. Sorry, 1 p.m. That's 13 o'clock. So we hit our TP at that same time. So it's also saw a fall because USD is very, very strong. I don't know if it's called the. excuse me. Expected a weak USD, but we are seeing a very strong momentum now on the USD. So now let's go now to the topic and the major chart for the day. It's supposed to be this one. Now. This one now it was posted. You can see it was posted on that thing on the 16th of August. Yeah, before I start, please, because they say I don't normally ask people to subscribe to our. Please, can you please just subscribe to our YouTube channel and also like and also share it with your friends so that they can as well learn, so that they don't fall for these guys. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel. The link is below, and also follow us on Instagram, follow us on Facebook, and share this post, please, because they say I don't normally say that. This stuff. So this is on the 16th of August, that same day. So I don't know if I have this one. Please let me just pause this video so I can bring it out from the email. Let me just quickly bring that from the email.
Okay.
Yeah, so here we have it. Let me just stop this share so I'm sure that you guys can see me. Yeah, so let me share again. So I want to just show you something I spotted, because if you analyze the, if you check the chart very well, so this is the scan that was sent out that same day. I just had to pull it out from the email because I can actually zoom in and zoom out here, but this is the scan. This is not the live chart. You can see it here, but on Instagram you can't zoom out. I'm not sure if I'm able to, but I'm sorry, but I can't zoom out. But you can go to our Instagram page. It was posted on the 16th of August. So this is better. So this was the chart. So I want to show you something so that even people on Monday or Tuesday, I'll be speaking more on what will be best for you as a trader, depending on your schedule. So you don't go about looking for signals. So you see, my our bias was a long position. This was what happened. I spotted a doji on a daily time frame at this level, and I spotted the bullish engulfing pattern on a daily basis, on the daily time frame at this level where I'm using this mouse cursor now to. So then, due to that, because of that, my bias was a long position. I did two setup. I posted this setup. I was waiting for confirmation to either extend my bias or take my profit and leave. So that was why I said, if you see what I said, the first setup, I was looking for a multiple target to 1.80, which was at this level where I just drew a trend line. Yeah, arrow line too, but this was my bias. Our bias was long position above 1.4, which was at this level. We target at 1.26356 and 1.26716 in extension. And I said first setup, because like I said, I like to detail so that I know if I come to this chart now, I can easily remember, okay, yes, this was this was my first setup to hit this tip. So I was waiting, once we hit the first TP, I was waiting for a pattern at this level, because I also spotted the doji on a daily time frame. I was now hoping for a pattern here on a 1 hour time frame to either confirm if I'm going long or I'm exiting the market at this level. So now let's go now to the live market scan so that I will show you something that actually occurred. Now this is the live market scan. It's on the 1 hour time frame, because like I said, I spotted a doji here. You see, let me just move this thing so that I can have a screen. I hope you can see this. I'm just moving it. So this is a live market. Now I'm still I just adjusted our position, and because we are still in this market now, I'm checking, that's what I told you before, I'm still checking it. We are still in this market. I just adjusted, because I saw another pattern that gave me, that was one of the reason why I didn't sleep, but I finished then and started studying and all that, and I've not even slept now, like as I'm speaking to you. So just pardon the drawings, I will increase it now. So look at the what I saw. This was my first target and my second target. If I spot, I was looking for a pattern here to either confirm to me that yes, the trend is still continuing, or no. If I spotted a bearish engulfing pattern at this level, even on the 1 hour time frame, I will exit the market immediately. But I was looking for a doji pattern to either validate, okay, this is a mistake, we are continuing with our trend. Because the dragonfly, that was what I was waiting for here, because I spotted the doji here. So I was expecting another level. If you see where this let's just go back now so you are sure, so you don't fall for it. You see where this is the scan. I can't edit this one because it's a scan. I can only zoom out. So I was waiting for a doji here, because I spotted a doji here that gave us confirmed, and later at this level it was invalidated. So I spotted a bullish engulfing pattern that gave me a buy signal. So I was expecting, if there's a touch here that signal a bearish reversal at this level, then I'm out of the market. But if I spot a dragonfly that says, oh, this candlestick was just a mistake, then we are moving forward, then I will increase our position. So this was the scan that was sent out. So you are sure. Sorry, I'd like to check if there's any news on candles into because need to be updated. That's why I always say to people, I'm always, you see now my Wall Street journal paper, I get download, like I receive Wall Street Journal newspaper downloaded automatically on my phone every day that I go through and see what's going on in the market, because you cannot be a forex trader and investor without knowing what's going on. You can see now, this is the Wall Street Journal. My paper has been done, my newspaper has been downloaded. So once I finish now, I'll go through and check what was on the news. So you can't just be a forex trader and just one-sided, one technical thing, don't know what's going on in the world. So like I said, look, this was the chart on the, look at the date here. So it's not about let's say I how did this one happen, or no, you tell us what's going on. So you can go to our Instagram page. So now we actually saw a continuation. Let me just zoom out. I hope if you don't mind, I will just zoom out so I can take this thing out, but I will still come back to the write-up. So now we saw, this was when the chart was drawn. We got into the market at this level, this candle, red candlestick, activated our position. Then we saw a continuation. And if you take, if you pay attention to DT, if you see the trend line that I drew, you saw when we got to this place, we saw a struggle at this line, respecting this line. It was first confirmation that we're going up, upward. So if you are able to analyze your chart detail, you see this is not a fluke. This is not a guesswork. Let me just zoom out. You saw this candlestick here. We saw a doji here. We saw another armor here. Then the confirmation. Then we now saw another armor doji. And then we saw a dragonfly. You see? We saw another doji here, like a armor doji, and then we saw a dragonfly. That signified that, oh, this area was a mistake, because you see it was it opened and closed at the same level. So it was just saying, no, this, sorry, is a mistake. We are actually, this is a confirmation to say now, this candlestick is the confirmation to tell you now that, yes, this is a doji fly. We are going upward. So then we saw a continuation. I will show you what gave me the bias. So we actually eat our TP1, and we eat our TP1. This level, we saw a continuation, but no, we need a breather. I always tell people, then we saw a pullback. It respected this level. At this level, now we spotted another, it wasn't a doji, but then it wasn't even a bullish engulfing pattern, but I was, immediately we hit our TP1 and we saw a pullback that respected this level. You see, if you go back to my chart now, you see the line, the trend line I drew. Someone said, I said, yes, because why? It's because I like to detail my chart. I know where it's coming from and where we're going to, so that I have that confidence and that, because like I said, what the decision we are making in the market is based on probability. You understand? So the reason why my probability is stronger, I keep on repeating. Repeating this, the reason why my probability is stronger than this is because I'm able to merge it with previous data to be sure and confident that yes, what I'm going into is what the right choice. So we now saw a rejection, a struggle at this level. You see these two lines here. It was in between. It wasn't apart from this candlestick that broke out, and then it was in between this line. Then here's the interesting. So we saw a continuation now to hit our TP. This was the level I was expecting a pattern, a doji pattern, to signal to me that yes, bro, we are still. Let me just zoom in. Yeah, this was the at this level, but I just moved it. It was supposed to be here. So now I got my signal to say, if you can see very well. Let me just, if you can see it very well, we I was waiting for a pattern here to signal to me that are we still going long? Because if you see where I drew this thing from, this was just a line. This was my outrider. So I was waiting any pattern that builds up here, any signal that I notice at this level, will either give me a continuation to even hit my TP2 or a pullout from the market, lock my profit. So then I now spotted this dodgy confirmation, the slide, because you know, dragonfly is when you see a dodgy armor, you see it opens and close. This like a dodgy cross. Then we saw it that a dodgy armor. When you spot a dodgy armor and then the next candle is a bullish full candle, then that gives you the signal that this area was just a mistake, because dodgy is like when you say something is a mistake. So now it now gave me the signal. So when I spotted the first dodgy candle, I now focused on. I spotted it here. So but then it did the next candle just invalidated. So I spotted it again. Now I now gave in to it. So I spotted it, then good, one confirmation. I spotted another confirmation again. This is a cross. Then I now spotted the armor dodgy. The next candle became pivotal to my decision of either if I'm staying in this trade or if I'm exiting. I'm just trying to build your, so that you have this, what's it called, this understanding of the market, how the market operates. So now, immediately I spotted this dodgy, the next candlestick was the full candle that covered everything, and that gave me the confirmation that, yeah, we are going long. Yeah, then we now hit our TP2, I adjusted, and that was why I did the setup to actually go hit our TP3. Immediately we hit our TP3 there again, we got out of the market here. So then I saw now there was another pattern that was building here again. Then we entered the market that last night now. So our exit now, our take profit now on this new position now is price swap, because we entered at 1, 2. Yeah, our take profit is TP is 1.29923. Let me check. 1.299. That's our, I told you people, we don't show you our account. Those guys that go on internet to show you their fake demo account, they are trying to catch you. If you know what you do, you don't need to convince anybody. The chart that I analyze now will convince you that this guy knows what he's saying. If I don't, we don't, nobody knows it, or we are all learning in this market. So the price is 1.29923. This is our take profit on this last trade now. Or is USD a long way, but we're almost there. So this was just we exited the market at this level. We got out from the market from at this level. That was when I did it. Another setup was we exited the market at this level. So now we saw 1.0. Yeah, this was our entry level again. It was 1.2755. Yeah. So this, you see now, because I always tell people, if you know what you're doing, no one can cajole you to come and buy something that is not logical. You are deceiving yourself. Someone is deceiving you instead of you to see that. And I will think and ask questions. This was the chart that was sent out on Monday, where we were still here. And then I did my chart, like the scenario 2 is there, that if there's a breakout from this level now, then I know that, well, because for further downside to 1.23 this level, and then continuation to actually hit the second TP alternative, So this is what I want to pass out. This is just a confirmation of the pick that was sent out on Monday. One of the pick, because I, like I said, I analyze a lot of chart, but I just normally send out one, then the rest we are on them. So this is the pick. I just wanted to show you how to spot a doji to either signal to you that are we going forward or would there be a reversal. This was the level here that gave me, where is it? This is the three candle, the doji one, two, three, and we saw the hammer, and then we saw the dragonfly. This was the doji that gave us the dragonfly to say yes, this was just a mistake. We'll continue our trend. Don't bother yourself. So as you can see, this is the chart that was sent out. This was the chart that was sent out. This is the our Instagram page. You can go and check it. It was posted 4 days ago. That was on the 16th of August 2021. And you can just see, if you can go on Instagram, I think you can zoom it from your phone. Well, I don't know why I can't zoom in on the laptop, from the laptop computer. So you can see it there. Everything is detailed there. And then you see the confirmation. It's not a guesswork. This is the other one I posted the last time. We finally saw it at TP3. Then we're seeing a continuation, but I'm not in this trade. I wanted to actually analyze because I saw that US dollar is very strong now. The pair against every currency on US dollar is very, very strong. So, my account was filled up. Open two new life account today just to open some position, so there was a lot of opportunity in the market this week coming from the I also traded more on New Zealand dollar because it went on lockdown for 3 days. I don't know if they're going out now. So this is it. So you understand this is the sorry, not this one again. So as you can see, this is the live market scanner and what actually happened. So it's not a guesswork. This is the chart that was sent out. You can see, I don't know why they don't add time again to, I'll check on it, see if I can edit and set it. Go on setting. So what you can see, go to the YouTube, Facebook, and see the chart there. So let me just stop this here. So please, I don't want you to keep falling for these guys that don't know what they're doing. They want to cajole you. Some of them now will go as far as renting a car and then trying to impress you that, why are you impressing me? People understand that, oh, this guy, I've never, someone sent me, please. Yes, I just remember now, please, because they also told me to say this, please. I don't have any WhatsApp, what's it called? WhatsApp group for traders. I told you this thing. Don't want fall for people because someone sent me that WhatsApp and group. Please listen to this carefully. I don't have any WhatsApp group. I don't respond to DMs. On Instagram, the only people on our company's Facebook, on my personal Instagram, the only people I respond to are people that I know personally and I'm following them. That's the people I respond to. The reason why is not because I want to ignore people, or maybe I don't care, or I'm rude to people. The reason why is this: so we can avoid this kind of situation, this scammer. Because last time they opened the account. They opened the Instagram account with my details and picture and everything. Took my picture from my personal page and posted it on the page, and started asking people to come and subscribe to their listing that it was me. So it was one the last one, it was one of my friend that WhatsApp me, because he's a close part, WhatsApp me and said, are you the one asking, look at the message I'm getting, did you open another Instagram page? I said no. He said, look, I now forwarded the email and saw that people will do. So I reported it to Instagram. They now, I think they closed the account. So that's why you see, it's not that I want to be rude to you. It's just that I need to avoid some certain issues so that you don't fall in the hands of these people. If you want to reach me, I've said this before. If you want to reach me, if you go to the Instagram, our Instagram page, you'll see the company's, the company's website. Go to the company's website. You'll see the contact form. Send an email to that contact form. Once it, if you can indicate on the email that you want to speak to me, then once the email gets to me, forward to me, then I will respond to your email. Then you can have my personal email. So if there's anything you need to ask me, then we can have a conversation. And I don't mind if you can even do a Zoom call if it is that important. I can create time to speak to you. So I don't respond to DM so that you are aware, so that you don't fall in the hands of these people. It's not that I want to ignore you. It's just to avoid this sort of issue. We don't have any WhatsApp group. Please don't fall for it, because it got to my notice this week that WhatsApp group. I don't have any WhatsApp group. I did not create any WhatsApp group. Well, to not bring people, and then you want to subscribe, so you'll be getting first signal. The signal I send out, I send it out on Instagram and Facebook, and they are all free. If you go there, you will see them. The only thing I ask for you, subscribe to our YouTube channel, follow us on Instagram, follow us on Facebook, so that when I post that, you are able to see the post and then make a pick. And also, they said I should say what to me. I don't know. Let's see if you turn on the notification on the YouTube, so that once we post a video, you can easily get a notification as well. Like I said, I just want our YouTube to get to a certain stage, a certain level, then I can at least maybe once in a while organize a webinar live, so I can show you some pattern, because there's a lot of pattern that you can spot that will give you the confidence to go into the market and actually execute a trade. But if you are just diving into the market with that, you don't even know what's going on. You don't know what you're doing, because someone sent you this thing. You will keep on losing money time. Yeah. So there are some trade that I go into, and there's a reversal. I know when to get out. I know when my state, when people use their Fibonacci retrenchment just to draw 50% Fibonacci and draw the support, the trade and the entry and exit and stop loss and all that. That's not how I position my stop loss. I know where my stop loss is supposed to be. I know where my entry is supposed to be. That's what I developed myself. It's not where, and it has been working for me. So I know some people are good with that Fibonacci and they know how to, and again, they still eat stop loss, but whatever works for you in the market, stick to it. And if you are able to learn other strategy, please go for it, because no information, no knowledge is lost in this life. Whatever you learn, stick to you. What you've learned, nothing. Nobody can take it away from you. It's already there. So that's what you need to understand. Please don't fall for this guy. We don't have any WhatsApp. I'm not some people even were close friends of mine. I'm not able to even respond to every message, I'll not gather people. No, like I said the last time, this year is just, I'm just focusing on learning as much as I can. By next year, I get a lot of email that please, mentorship, but I'm not ready yet for that this year. This year is about learning for me. Then maybe next year, then we'll come together, because like I said, I'm really passionate about building a community of forex traders and investors that can not shift their mindset from just forex trading into long-term investing, where you can just leave the money, buy a stock. You know, you will now be analyzing financial statement, annual report, and all that, not just chat alone, so that at least you can move your mindset now and go on a longer period of investment. So you can measure up with the Warren Buffett and the rest of them. They are not first, they buy stock and leave it. So you can be doing your trading and then move money from stock now to investment and then leave it there for some time, for a year. If you don't need it, just leave it there so you can be building wealth for yourself, and then you build wealth for your generation that are unborn. I'm not obliged to show you anybody my account. It's not your money, it's my money. I'm not going to come online and start showing you, oh, let's look at my account. I can show you, oh, this is the percentage of a trade that I just took, the percentage that I got, but I won't show you the amount because it's not your money. That is not a way of encouraging people. It's just a way, that is a way of convincing people. You understand? That's not a way of encouraging people. It's just a way of convincing people to fall for you, for your trap. If you want to encourage people and convince people rightly, then you go on the chat and analyze the chat for them. Even if they pick it on their own, without you even being there with them, they can at least make, or even if they are making $1, it's something. Understand? So that's what I just wanted to say. I'm really, really tired today. I've not slept, like I said before. So today's Friday. It's already in the trading week. So I wish you a wonderful weekend, and I hope your week was profitable, and I hope your weekend will be peaceful and restful. So again, I'll speak to you maybe on Monday. I'll send that chat again on Monday. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel. Subscribe to our follow us on Instagram, YouTube, Facebook. Share to people so that they don't fall. Share to your friends that are also in trade. Share it on your wall so that people can see and then don't fall for these guys. Share it on wherever any platform that you deem fit, so that others can see and then move their mindset. Because until you have a shift until you have that awareness of what goes on in the market, we'll keep on falling for these guys, because those things it doesn't work. I promise you that it doesn't work. It has never worked. It's never going to work. So don't fall for these guys. So I'll speak to you again on Monday. Let me get some rest in time. And have a lovely, lovely day, and enjoy your weekend.